हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन स्टडी फॉर यू, वन स्टेप सॉल्यूशन फॉर ऑल योर प्लेसमेंट नीड्स। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टेक्निकल एंड कोडिंग क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वर आस्क्ड टुडे इन स्लॉट वन ऑफ टीसीएस एनक्यूटी एग्जामिनेशंस। यस, मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स वर नॉट एबल टू टेक द एग्जाम कम्प्लीटली ड्यू टू द सर्वर प्रॉब्लम व्हिच वाज नॉट ओनली प्लेस्ड इन होम टेस्ट बट इन सेंटर टेस्ट ऑल्सो दिस द सेम प्रॉब्लम ऑकर्ड। So most of them were not able to take completely, but we have solved some of the questions which have asked technical MCQs as well as the coding questions. So we will be discussing those questions, all those coding questions also along with the solutions. So without wasting much time, let's move ahead. Here, as you can see, in this question one, it is related to Java language. Okay. So here you can see there is no syntax error, but you will when you will see here, you will think that this is wrong. Let me just take highlighter again. Okay, you will think that this is wrong, that this is dollar sign, which is not a valid variable name, because we learned underscore can be only in characters, but that is only in C language and Python language. But when we talk about Java, a dollar can also be a variable name. It is a valid variable name, right? So there is no problem, but since nothing is printing, so the correct output will be, the correct option is nothing will print. So this was simple, but those who are not known with Java, only known about C, C++, Python, they must be not knowing it, because this dollar is only allowed here. Okay, now coming to this question number two, here you can see again a Java program. So there are two loops. Okay, so this outer loop and then inner loop, and then some calculation is being done. And then we are doing some printing, then break statement. Okay, so what will happen? Let's start from the very starting. Here you can see that it is not type of MCQ what is written, that what it is asked, that what will be printed when above sample code is executed. Enter your answer only as a numeral. So what will happen, that a box will be available where you will need to write what is the output you are getting. A big box will be there. Okay, it was there below this one. We have not included that. So here, when I start in the first iteration, I is equals to 0. Then j equals to 0, I plus j, that is 0 plus 0, and x is minus 1. We have to print minus 1. Right, minus 1. Now what we will do, we will think that because of our habit, when we will be printing next thing, we will come to this next line, but we will not do so, because here you can see it is not println. It is simple written print. If there would have been println, then it means that we have to print from the next line, but it is simple print. It means we will continue the next printing also from here only. Now after printing this minus one, what we will see, we saw a break statement. Now what break statement will do, it will take the control outside of this for loop only, right? Break, whenever it a break statement is encountered, it checks for the nearest braces, nearest case where something starting, nearest block you can say by these, and it gets outside of that. So it will get outside of this inner loop only. Okay, so now what will happen, that this break statement, but this system.out.printx is not inside this for loop, right? You can see that here the braces are not present. It means that this would be considered outside this for loop. Hence, this will only run once when this outer for loop will end. So what will happen when break is encountered, then again it will reach to this outer for loop. I will become 1. J will be still 0. 1 plus 0, 1, 1 minus 1. So it will be 0. Right. And again break. So then I will become 2. 2 plus 0, nothing. 2 minus 1, 1. Simply then 2, then again what will happen, I will be 4. So 4 minus 1 will be 3. Then what will happen after this, I will become 5, and 5 is not less than 5, then this loop will terminate and control will come outside this loop here. Now here we are printing again the value of x, which will be as same as what was the value last time. So last time it was 3, again this will be printed. So this would be the output, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3. Now coming to this question, we can see this is a question from C concept. So it is written which of the following option best suits for memory leak occurred. That means it's related to the dangling pointer problem, right? So resource allocation pending while debugging the code, no. Program releases resource allocated in memory. Okay, let us keep it. We will check it. This one. Program does not free the memory which is allocated dynamically. Yes, this seems also right. We will check this. Occurs due to address assignment failure. No. It's not related to any address assignment failure. Now, program releases resources allocated in memory. It's not so in case of dangling pointer, but since these two, we felt that these two seems closer to what could be the actual answer. Now, when we will read this third point, program does not free the memory, which is allocated dynamically. So when we will assume that when we works with that linked list, we are implementing with C, what we used to do is that we at the end, we free that address which we have taken by using that free function. We know that free is one of the function of DMA. Here, the same problem happens when program does not free the memory, which is allocated dynamically, then that memory leak problem actually happens. So this one is also wrong. The correct or most accurate answer will be this third one. Okay, so when we declare constant pointer to integer, what we can't change? Before this, I would like to remind you one thing, that when we have a variable that is constant, integer variable or something like that, in that case, what we do, I'm not talking about pointer, constant variables, constant integer only, those variables, not a pointer. What we can't change, we can't change its value because it's written like this. Const I and some value is passed, I think here, may or may not be, but mostly yes. So it is written like this. So what we can do is we can't change its value. When you try so, then it gives error, right? But since now we are talking about constant pointer, so in this case, the condition is address in pointer variable. When we declare constant pointer to integer, we cannot change address in pointer variable, because when we are working with pointer, then it all works with address and only. So things what change is that in this the value can't be changed, and here we talk about address in pointer variable when we name it as constant. So address in pointer variable cannot be changed. Okay, so here now we have a question from data structures. You can see a tree is given here. Okay, and she consider the following tree, what will be the pre-order traversal, right? So there was some question in this problem what TCS gave, because I would like to tell you that if it's a pre-order traversal, when we when you do tree pre-order traversal, what we do is just take a pencil from the starting node or the root node and just traverse through everything, and as you mark means as you reach any node, you should mark it, right? The pre-order traversal for this tree will be actually A, B, D, okay, A, B, D, then E, H, F, I, C, and G. Because as we are encountering at the very first time, we have to write it because it is pre-order traversal, means first time. But as we can notice that in these options, none of the options matches with it. So the correct answer is A, B, D, E, S, and we can see here no one is matching with it. So this question means options were the given options were actually wrong. So correct answer is this only, which I have just told you, A, B, D, E, H, F, I, G, C. Okay, if it would have been I will tell you in order traversal, then what we would have done, let me just erase it. Okay, so if it would have been in order traversal, if you do, then what you do before starting, whatever the leaf nodes or these type of nodes you see, you just mark them like this. Here also like this, here like this, this way. Okay. So now what I will do, I will take a different color so it will be easier. Yeah. So now we have to, since we are doing in order traversal, we have to mark when we reach that node second time. So first time, and then second time. So then D, first time D will be printed. Then again B, because B is reached now second time, B. Now E is first time, no problem. H is first time. Now H is second time. Now H will be printed. Okay, H is already done. Now E is second time. E will be printed. Then it would be okay. From here, then it will reach A. A would be also second time. A will be printed. C not because first time. F not because first time. Then again F second time. F will be printed. A first time not. A second time. Yes, I will be printed. Then it will come here. C first time will not be printed. G first time will not be printed. G second time will be printed. Then C second time will be printed. So hope you understand it. In pre-order, we were taking that first time when we reached the node, we printed it. In order, when we are reaching that node, second time you are printing it. And similarly, if you would be working with post-order traversal, we will print it the third time when we will reach the node. So there is a homework also for you that please comment down that what will be the output of in-order traversal, which I just told you. So what will be the output of in-order traversal for this tree? Okay, now coming to the coding question. This was very easy one. We also got to know about one, two other questions also, which were quite easy, but we are not having the exact questions. So we are only displaying this one also. We will soon uploading another video where we will discuss that, those two, three also. Those are also very easy, simple, if else, nothing else. So here, there is a jar full of candies for sale at a mall counter. Jar has the capacity n, that is jar can contain maximum n candies. Okay, max n candies. Okay, when jar is full, at any point of time jar can have m number of candies where m less than equals to n. Okay, so these things you can avoid also because these things are not yet related to what we have to do. Candies are served to customer, jar is never remain empty, jar is filled with new candies in such a way jar gets full. Write a code to implement above scenario. Display jar at counter with available number of candies. Input should be number of candies one customer can order. Update the jar after each purchase. So as we also saw in the DRC also, sample test also, and here also, the statement which they have written is not very easy to understanding, but the sample means these the test cases or the examples given anywhere makes the things very easier. Before going to these examples, what we should notice is we are given some conditions here. The conditions are that number of candies available means max number is n is 10, means initially before customer asks for something it is 10, and minimum number of candies which can be which should remain in the that jar is 5. It means the customer must not ask more than 5, right? So what is happening here? If the customer asks for more than 5, what we will do, that would we'll also get to understand here. In example 1, we can see N10K5, that is given in question only. So input value is 3. It means N is 10 and customer has asked 3. So output is number of candies sold 3 and number of this candies left is 7. Similarly, but when input value is 0, so this was not actually given here. Here it was only given that if customer asking candies more than 5, then we should give output as invalid input. Okay, if more than candies in jar. But here from this example, we also got to know that if input value is 0, it means customer is not asking anything, then also we should output invalid input, and then we will write number of candies left as 10. So that's why I'm saying that this is not, the question is not very self-explanatory very well. So we should read examples also. Now what I will do, let me just move to the coding part. Before moving ahead, I want to tell you here about some material which we have especially prepared for you guys so that you can do good in your test. So what you need to do only, you have to just search our YouTube channel name on Google, that is Online Study for You. And then going to this very first link.
Now friends, I will take you through the quiz contest. So friends, if you click on the quiz contest, then we have quiz here, click on that. And then you can see TCS NQT 2021 special quiz. So friends, we have free quiz and then we have paid quiz. So friends, paid quiz, for 10 quiz we have just put the price 49 rupees. So friends, first you take the free quiz, and if you like, because we have already included SDLC and decision making, all these kind of problems, so you can go through the free quiz and then you can go for the paid quiz. So 10 quiz will be available in the paid quiz. And friends, we have also released the TCS NQT crash course, and that is just for 249 rupees. So friends, in these 4-5 days, if you go through these courses, then there is a huge chance that you are going to crack the TCS examination like last year, where we had given more than 5000.
Okay class, so I'll be using this online compiler, online GDB. You can also search for it. If you only search online C compiler, online Java compiler, you will get this in the very first link in Google. So let us just start with our coding part. I am going to code this one in C. If you want the solution in other languages as well, please comment down if you want it in Python or C++ or Java, right? So let's start. So firstly, we will include our header files, hash include std.h in main. I don't think these requires any explanation, so I'm just quickly writing this up and we'll be moving forward. Then, as we know that max is 10 and means the max capacity is 10 and max number of candies which a customer can ask for is 5. This was the same variable I'm using, which were used there also, so that you can easily correlate, and is 10 k equals 5. Now I'll take that input, because we have to take the input also from the user, that how much candies the customer actually wants. Okay, so we have taken the input. I've missed one thing, that I should also declare this variable int num. Now it's fine. Now what I'll do, I will check that how much if he has asked is according to our conditions or not. So we learned two things, that the input must not be zero, means greater than or equals to one. Along with it, it should also be less than equals to 5. Here we could have avoided this k also. We could have directly used 5, because now this is constant, means this is always 10 or 5, right? But we can write it this way also. So num greater should be greater than 1 and not greater than 5. Greater than 0, not greater than 5. Here what I will write, printf, the same statement what it was like there. So we have to write it very similarly. Number of candies sold. We can write a colon here. And then percentage d slash n num. So what I have done here, an error here from my side. I have used here. Okay, so what I have done, what it will print, number of candies sold, percentage d slash, and will help in the next line will be means after this one line gap, means the counter will go to the next line, so that when next line will be printed, number of candies left or something like that. So it will come in next line only according to the output we saw. So here percent d I have written, which is referring to this num. Number of candies sold, it will write it this way, and number of candies left, I will write it. It's also then here we won't be requiring slash n, because we don't have to write anything here. So now what I will write here, I'll write here n minus num, right? Why n minus num? Because we know the candies left will be how much sold and then left. And since we know that these are actually constant, then we don't actually require taking n and k here. So what we can do, that here num is right. Here we can write simply 10 minus num, right? Because since those are constant, the values are not changing. It's always 10, 5 is given in quotients. We don't require it to saving it in a variable and something. And here our condition ends. it is for that condition when a condition is according to means positive conditions. Now for negative conditions means conditions not according to the, which will give a good output. So it is printf. What we have to write, we just got to know invalid output. Right, and then slash n also, because we know that even when it is invalid output, still we have to write that statement again, that how many candies are now left. So in next line, what I will write, printf caps lock on number of candies left, and again that the same things which I will do, that percentage d and yep, this n. Why n? Actually 10, because as we know that we have removed this n here, and we are writing the similarly what actually is, because it is constant, we don't need to save it any variable. Okay, so now it's done. We will return 0. Zero means here successful completion of the function, and now we will run it and we will see if it's working fine or not. So let's see if there are any errors that we will also get to. It's actually a good compiler. So what value do you want me to give? Let's give 3. Okay, this is very good. Okay, the output is come. Okay, the number spelling, sorry for that. Yeah. Okay, now let's try it for some other values. Now let's do some boundary value analysis. For 5, yes, it's working. Now I will take 2 values which will give negative outputs. For 0, accurate. And now I will try for just 1. I'm taking more than 5, that means I'm taking 7 now. Okay, so now it's done. Hope you students enjoyed it and learned the whatever I told you. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to this channel. You can, as I told you, you can also go through our channel videos. We have also uploaded today's questions which are asked in slot 1 from quant sections, reasoning sections also, and soon we'll be uploading for English also. So thank you very much. And please comment down if you want some more questions or other codes also to be solved.